The concept is that you
right on
effect of source inductance or source impedance. Source inductance effect of source inductance. On single phase full wave rectifier, effect of source inductance on single phase full wave rectifier. Yes, let us consider the source inductance or source impedance. Effect of source inductance or source impedance. Okay, this you take a source impedance, effect of source inductance, or it may be this concept is also applicable for source impedance. Effect of source inductance or source impedance. Effect of source inductance or source impedance. Okay. For that, let us consider a single phase full wave bridge rectifier with the source inductance. A single phase full wave bridge rectifier with the source inductance. Is T1, T3, T4, T2. Let this is load. Assuming that we are supplying the constant current to the load. I0 is constant. This V0. Okay. We supply. Let LS is source inductance. Let's parallel draw the circuit. Don't wait. Yes, the supply voltage Vs equal to Vm sin omega t, where Ls is source inductance. Yes. Now listen please. This concept I want to explain. If source inductance is considered, now what is the effect on the operation of this rectifier? That you will see. For that, let us consider waveforms. To explain this concept, let us consider waveforms first. Yes.
Yes, this is pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, this omega t. For easily projecting the waveforms, for easily drawing of waveforms, I am projecting dotted lines like this. Okay. For simplicity, I am drawing Vs and V naught on the same axis. This omega t. Okay. This also, this is 3 pi. This is 2 pi, that you remember. Concentrate on this. Okay. This 2 pi, 3 pi. Yes. This I am drawing I naught waveform, load current. Let us assume that we are supplying the constant current to the load. This I naught is constant. I am neglecting ripples. Let us assume that we are supplying the constant current to the load. Neglect the ripples. This I naught remains constant. And this is firing angle alpha. This also firing angle alpha. Okay. And this also firing angle alpha. Yes. This angle is alpha. This is pi plus alpha. Concentrate. This is 2 pi plus alpha. This also alpha. This is also alpha. Okay. First, draw the waveform up to this. Remaining whatever the waveform I will draw. After explaining total concept, then we can represent. There is some modification is there. Okay. First, I am drawing the waveforms without source inductance. This waveform is without source inductance. Okay. We know that. In a single phase full wave bridge rectifier, supplying the constant current to the load without source inductance, that you know, at omega t equal to alpha t1 t2 is triggered, it will conduct up to pi plus alpha. At pi plus alpha t3 t4 is triggered, it will conduct up to 2 pi plus alpha. At 2 pi plus alpha again t1 t2 is triggered, it will conduct 3 pi plus alpha. This waveform, you know, this is without the source inductance. Here which device is conducting? T1, T2. Here which device is conducting? T3, T4. Here which device is conducting? T1, T2. If you assume that after some cycles, before T1, T2, already which device is conducting? T3, T4. Here T3, T4 is conducting. These are the waveforms we are drawn without a source inductance, without any effect of source inductance. These waveforms you already know, and we are supplying the constant current to the load. Now the concept is, here which device is conducting? T3, T4 is conducting. Here which device is conducting? T1, T2 is conducting. Here also which device is conducting? T1, T2 is conducting. sorry, yes. Here which device is conducting? T3, T4. It also T3, T4. Here T1, T2.
Assuming the constant current to the load. If you don't consider any effect of source inductance, this is the waveform. Tell me. If we consider the effect of source inductance, if source inductance is considered, we know that the current through T1, T2 is passing through inductance now. The current through T3, T4 is also passing through inductance only now. Yes, sir. If T1, T2 is conducting, what the path for conduction of T1, T2? This is the path. This is the path. Like this, it is conduct through inductance only. Even T3, T4 is also conduct through inductance only. That means, without any source inductance, we are supplying the constant current and we get the waveform like this. These are the waveforms I drawn without source inductance. Now, if source inductance is considered, what is the effect? We know that. The current through T1, T2 and current through T3, T4 is passing through inductance only. Then what is the property of inductor? Inductor cannot allow the sudden change of current. That is the property of inductor. That you know. The fundamental property of inductor is it cannot allow the sudden change of current. That means for sudden change, the inductor acts as an open circuit. Once the inductor acts as an open circuit means it cannot allow the sudden change of current. That means if it cannot allow the sudden change of current means we know that. If you don't consider any effect of source inductance, here at this instant, T3, T4 current is suddenly falling, T1, T2 current is suddenly rising. You don't consider any effect, source inductance effect. At this instant, T1, T2 current is suddenly falling, T3, T4 current is suddenly rising. This is applicable if there is no any inductance, source inductance. But if we consider the source inductance, current through T1, T2 is passing through inductance only. Current through T3, T4 is also passing through inductance only. That's the reason why. Because of source inductance, current through T1, T2 and T3, T4 is not suddenly falling and is not suddenly rising because inductor cannot allow the sudden change of current. That is the main effect here. What happening? That means, because of source inductance, current through T1, T2 and T3, T4 is not suddenly falling, and suddenly rising, because inductor cannot allow sudden change of currents. Cannot allow sudden change of currents. Now what happening? Because of this, what happening in the waveforms? That you will see. The current through T1, T2 and current through T3, T4 is not suddenly rising and is not suddenly falling means because of source inductance, at this instant T3, T4 is turned off. The current is not suddenly falling, slowly falling. The current through T3, T4 is not suddenly falling, is slowly falling. The current through T1, T2 is not suddenly rising, slowly rising. Then after that, it supplies the constant current. That is. Here, now T1, T2 is conducting I0. During this instant,
T3, T4 current is falling and T1, T2 current is rising. Means all the devices are on state. Here also same. During this instant, T1, T2 current is slowly falling. T3, T4 current is slowly rising. During this instant, all the four devices are on state. T1, T2 is falling. T3, T4 is rising. During this instant, T3, T4 current is falling. T1, T2 current is rising. That means, during this instant, all the four devices are on state. Understood? What I am telling? Because of source inductance, current through incoming thyristor and current through outgoing thyristor is not suddenly rising, is not suddenly falling. Is not suddenly rising, is not suddenly falling means during some angle, that angle is taken as a overlap angle mu, that you project like this. This overlap angle mu. Let this angle is mu. Let this angle is mu. This angle is mu. This angle is mu. Where mu is overlap angle. Yes. During some angle, all the four thyristors are on state. If all the four thyristors are on state means T1 is on state, T2 is on state, T3 is on state, T4 is also on state. If all the devices are on state means then current will not enter into source. Then current will be circulated here only. Like this only current is circulated. If all the devices are on state means load is short circuited. Understood? This is also on condition, this is also on condition, this is also on condition, this thyristor is also on condition. If all the thyristors are on state means actual path is T1, T2, T3, T4. Instead of current is flowing through T1, T2, T3, T4, current will be trying to flow like this, short path. All the devices are on state. Then load is short circuited. Load is short circuited means then output voltage falls to zero. During this angle, output voltage falls to zero. Then you get the wave shape like this. During this angle, output voltage falls to zero. Then you get the wave shape like this. During this angle, output voltage falls to zero. Then you get the output voltage wave shape like this. Okay, that is what is this waveform V naught. This is the effect of source inductance. This is V naught wave. Clear? Understand? Okay. Like this we are getting the wave shape. Note down first. This is I naught waveform. This is V naught waveform. This is effect of source inductance. Inductor cannot allow the sudden change of current. Now what happening? If current through incoming thyristor and outgoing thyristor is not rising suddenly, is not rising, is not falling suddenly means, because of this, what happening during some angle, because of source inductance, because of source inductance, because inductor cannot allow the sudden change of currents, na, due to this, due to this, during some angle mu, during some angle mu, some angle mu, all the four thyristors are overlap. All the four thyristors are overlap. Thyristors are overlap. And output voltage falls to zero. And output voltage falls to zero. And output voltage, this output voltage falls to zero. During some angle, all the four thyristors are overlap and output voltage falls to zero. Overlap in the sense load is short circuited. That is effect of source. Therefore, due to source inductance, what happening? One is, all the four thyristors are overlap. The another one is, average output voltage is reduced. The another observation is, listen please, actually without source inductance T1 T2 will conduct alpha 2 pi plus alpha. That means pi angle. But because of source inductance, is it T1 T2 turn off at pi plus alpha? No. Still it is conducting some extra angle. How much angle? Extra angle it is conducting. Here also T1 T2 is conducting. Actually without source inductance up to what angle it will conduct? Alpha 2 pi plus alpha. Alpha 2 pi plus alpha means pi. But because of source inductance, some extra angle it is conducting. How much angle? Mu angle. That means conduction angle is increased. Therefore, conduction angle gamma equal to pi plus mu. Conduction angle gamma equal to pi plus, actually pi. Because of source inductance, conduction angle is increased by mu. Mu angle, actually pi, but extra angle we are getting mu. That is pi plus mu. Another observation. Listen please. Without source inductance, we can control the output voltage from alpha itself. But from alpha to mu, in this, what is the output voltage? Zero. Are you controlling this output voltage? No. Understood? That's why we can control the output voltage from, this is mu and this is 180 degrees. Up to this is 180 degrees. Okay. Then this from this is mu means, this total is 180 degrees. This angle is alpha, this is mu. Okay. Then we can control the output voltage from mu to 180 minus mu only. Okay. This up to this is pi now. In one cycle, we are controlling output voltage. This is alpha. But this angle, mu angle, we are not controlling. Actually, we can control alpha to 180 degrees. But mu angle we are not controlling. That means output is controlled. Output is controlled. output is controlled. Output is controlled. That is mu less than alpha less than 180 minus mu.
During this angle only we can control the output. But for recovering the thyristor, if you take some extra angle, recovery angle, that means here T3, T4 is recovering. If we take some extra angle, recovery angle, if delta is given as some extra recovery angle, if delta is a recovery angle, some extra angle it is taking to change from conduction state to forward blocking mode. Recovery angle. If it is changing from, here we are not controlling. If it takes some extra angle, delta is recovery angle. This may be changes. The control angle is mu less than alpha 180 minus mu minus delta you take. If mu only given, this is the control range. If delta is also given, this is recovery angle. Recovery angle in the sense during from this state to changing from average in this state it is zero. Not only mu, some extra angle it takes, then that is taken as a recovery angle. Then if recovery angle is also given, this you take range of control. If it is not given, this you take range of control with respect to effect of source inductance. Okay. The range of control is, we are controlling from mu to 180. It is not alpha to 180. Understood? Okay. These are the effect of source inductance. That means due to source inductance, what happening? All the four thyristors are overlapped. Average output voltage is reduced. Conduction angle is increased. Gamma equal to pi plus mu. That is actually pi. Now the conduction angle is pi plus mu. Increased by mu. Then output is controlled only from mu to 180 minus mu only. We don't control from alpha itself. Then if delta is recovery angle, some extra angle it is taken. Mu less than alpha 180 minus mu minus delta. This range only we can control. The another point to remember, due to source inductance effect, source current is trapezoidal. We know that without source inductance, what the source current waveform? Square waveform. If we consider the effect of source inductance, if you draw the source current waveform, this waveform we can get, this one. Source current means source is subjected to bidirectional nature of current, this you can. Then if you assume that T1, T2 is conducting, this is the wave shape. If T3, T4 is conducting, means exactly opposite. Okay. This is one wave shape. Okay. Here this current will not flowing through source. Then we can get this one. This shape only. That means what is the shape? Trapezoidal. But source is subjected to bidirectional. This is positive means you take, this is negative. Are you getting square wave from here? No. That's why source current becomes trapezoidal. Okay. All these are the effects of source inductance. Okay. Because of source inductance, average output voltage reduced. All the four thyristors are overlapped. Conduction angle is increased. The control range is also changes. Source current becomes trapezoidal. Actually, without any source current, what is the source current? It is a square waveform, but it becomes trapezoidal waveform. This is the shape. The shape you will see. This is a trapezoid. But source is subjected to bidirectional. If you take T1, T2 is positive, then you take T3, T4 is negative. That how to draw, that I already explained. Okay. This about what is the effect of source inductance. Now I want to calculate due to source inductance effect, how much voltage is reduced? How much average output voltage is reduced? That I want to do the analysis. Clear? Understand? Okay. Now you do the analysis. Snowdom.